Welcome to Ajay Dwivedi's SQL Server classes. In last video tutorial, we saw how to install Windows Server 2012 on VM inside VMware Workstation. Today, we are going to make that virtual machine act as domain controller. So, let's begin. Inside VMware Workstation, we usually press Ctrl, Alt, and Insert. Then provide the password that you set up during last video session. Now the first thing we should make is we should install VMware tools. So go to VM. It's already installing on my system, that's why it is showing cancel VM tools installation. If it is otherwise in your case, just come here and click install VMware tools. Click next, complete, and install. I am going to pause this video and wait till this VM tools setup installation completes. Once VMware tools are installed inside your virtual machine, you will see that the entire screen stretches itself and occupies all the area. So click finish here, and it is asking to reboot your system, so I'm going to press yes and let it reboot my virtual machine. Okay, so my virtual machine has rebooted itself, and here we are on the welcome screen. I'm going to remove this library panel as well, so that we can have a large window to perform our activities. Now again press Ctrl Alt Insert from your keyboard instead of Ctrl Alt Delete. Now once you are inside the VM machine and you want to promote this server as domain controller, the very first thing you need to do is rename this virtual machine and provide it a static IP. So let's rename this virtual machine to DC. So right click on this PC and choose properties, then change settings on this system's properties, click change and provide name here. So I'm going to give it a name, DC. It is asking to reboot the system. We are going to say yes. So restart now. And I'll pause this video again and will resume once it is up again. So the VM has restarted. Press Ctrl Alt Insert, otherwise you can also press this button. Log inside to this VM using administrator account. Now let's give it a static IP. So right click network and sharing, under that click this Ethernet, then properties. Then choose Internet Protocol version 4, TCP/IP. Then click Properties. Here, give it a static IP. In my case, I prefer 20.20.20.10. And we don't need to provide anything else apart from these two. Subnet mask automatically will pop up once you enter this and press tab. So I think we are good here. So click OK and close and close. Now in order to promote this machine as domain controller, we need to install domain services feature of this virtual machine. So let's do that. Click this add roles and features inside server manager. Click next, next, next. Here choose this Active Directory domain services. Click next. We also wish to install .NET Framework 3.5, so choose this one as well. Next, next, reboot this system. Next. Also, it is saying that it might happen that the installed virtual machine operating system might not have the right setup, so we can also provide an alternate source path for installing .NET Framework. So let's see if our CD drive is already mounted or not. Yeah, it is. So we simply need to put it like this. D. So say since D is CD drive in my case. Click OK. Click install. And installation has started. So I'm going to pause this video again and resume it until we get some next pop-up window or screen. Okay, so feature installation is completed. You can see this configuration required, installation succeeded on DC. So click close and we are good. Since it did not demand for VM restart, so we are not going to do that either. Now let's promote this server to a domain controller. So click on this. Choose this option. Add a new forest and provide a domain name here. For our case, it would be sqllab.pri, so that the entire name for this virtual machine would be dc.sqllab.pri. Keep the settings default here, just provide the password for domain services restore mode. You can provide any password, but it must satisfy Windows password policy. You can ignore this pop-up window. Click next. Click next here as well. Next. Next. Click install. So now the installation has begun. Going to pause this video again and we'll resume once we see next screen. So asking for control or delete, I'm going to press this one. As you can see, now it is showing us the login name in two part way, domain name backward slash login name. So let's login using local account, that is administrator. Now the next step here is we have to create IP reverse lookup zone. So let's do that. So in order to create reverse lookup zone, click start, then type DNS. And click on reverse lookup zone, right click, new zone, next, choose primary zone, next. Here we have to choose to all DNS servers running on domain controllers in the forest. So the first one option, next, this is the fine. Now here type the subnet IP that you initially set for your domain controller. If you don't remember now, you can simply go so it should be 20.20.20. Keep it default and finish. Now let's create some logins and user IDs in Active Directory users and groups. So Active Directory users and computers, expand it, here it is. Since I am doing this for SQL Server Lab, so I am going to create a group SQL DBA. So new group SQL DBA, and good, make this group member of schema admin, domain admin and enterprise admin. So member of good, fine. Now so choose domain admins, enterprise admin, and at the last schema admin, click OK. We can remove this local admin. Okay. Okay. And let's create few domain users as well. Like I'm going to create one user under my name. I'm going to make that user member of SQL DBA group. Here it is, and we should be okay now. So just let's just log this off. And log in again using Ajay account. So you can see we are successful. We have logged in using SQL Lab /Ajay. That means SQL Lab domain, and Ajay is one admin member there. So thank you guys for watching this video. In this video we learned how to create a domain controller.